crews with the City of Pearl were out early Sunday morning putting de-icer on bridges around the city and at the Jackson Evers Airport. They say they were out here last night. They're out here again today, and they believe they're going to be out here later today and tomorrow because this is a round-the-clock effort to make sure that the bridges and overpasses here are not covered in ice.
Come out here last night about 4 o'clock yesterday afternoon and put it out on this bridge and other bridge up at the airport.
A spokesperson with the Jackson Megger Wiley's Evers International Airport said in a statement that the airport authority's safety operations team will be deploying a de-icing liquid to runways and taxiways, as well as adding light sprays on International Drive, public walkways, and on the second floor parking garage. At one point Sunday, the drop-off and pickup ramp was closed to traffic. Not far from Airport Road, Arthur Rodriguez says his car hit a patch of ice and ended up in a ditch.
The car started like shaking and going all crazy. So there was like a truck next to me. So I went on his lane, but I was like backward, like in front of him, but going backward, like sliding. And then there was another like 18-wheeler on the side. So I was trying not to hit them. I just tried to like move the steering wheel and I went all the way to the grass.
He was not hurt in the accident. Marcus Hunter, 16 WAPT News.
I'm glad he's okay. According to their website, all arriving and departing flights at Jackson Evers have been canceled this evening. MDOT out treating roads ahead of the winter storm. They have crews right now spreading salt and slag to ensure that major roadways and interstates remain passable as much as they can. While advised to stay off the roads if you don't have to be out, MDOT says if you do have to travel, be smart about it. Keep the following things in your car in case of emergencies. You really need to keep a windshield scraper, flashlight with some extra batteries. Make sure you have jumper cables, first aid kit, blankets, cell phone charger, water and snacks just in case you get stuck. Clinton City leaders closing the Parkway Bridge to traffic in both directions until Tuesday morning. City leaders urging residents to stay indoors and limit your trips if you can. If you have to travel, try to find an alternate, less traveled route. The City of Jackson closing several bridges tonight, starting in about a few minutes here at 6 p.m. In fact, Woodrow Wilson Avenue, Pearl Street, Bailey Avenue Extension, and Fortification Street and Mays Street all shutting down at 6 p.m. The city engineers say they are mobilizing to put down salt and sand in those troubled areas that we all see. They will focus both in North and South Jackson. They say they hope to get as many roads covered today before getting back out there tomorrow. The mayor urging everyone, if you can, please stay inside.
We ask that our residents take every necessary precaution when traveling our roads. If you do not have to travel, we ask that you do not travel across our roads. As you are aware, our infrastructure is not prepared for the winter weather that we often experience.
Now the time for sightseeing. The city has also opened a cold weather shelter over at Champions Gym on Hattiesburg Street. It's going to remain open until next Friday. This is what many around the metro have been seeing, that freezing rain falling all day. In fact, this image taken in Northeast Jackson, and you can see within that little rain, those steady bits of ice falling with it. We saw some sleet falling down outside our own station. Check it out. The light ice started to quickly accumulate on vehicles and the roadways around us. We even had some ice falling from one of our high towers high above our building. This is how the stack looking right now over as the freezing rain fell. We have someone shooting this for us. You can see a white sheet of precipitation right there on the interstate. And yeah, it looks glassy, doesn't it? People who have to be out in this, you really need to slow way down. Take a look at this, Interstate 220. It looks a little good right now. I think Brett Kenyon took this image for us. It looks good, but there's some ice there. There's those patches you got to watch out for. This is one of the trouble spots for some drivers. Again, slow down and be careful. Leave plenty of room between your vehicle and the one up front in front of you. Here's a look at what it looks like over in the Belhaven area. This looks like State Street, Belhaven, and the medical offices right there. A coat of freezing rain over that State Street area, and you know as the sun goes down, it's going to get more icy as we move forward. Many of you will start seeing icicles outside of your home. A viewer sent this in from Pearl. Are we going to see it? We're going on the next one. We'll get that later on another broadcast. Hey, today's performance, though, the Dixie National Rodeo will take place scheduled However, ticket holders that cannot make it there because of the winter weather can have their tickets reissued for Thursday's show at 7 p.m. I think that's Sawyer Brown. The show's scheduled for Monday. That's Sawyer Brown's been rescheduled for Thursday. Performances on Tuesday and Wednesday. Right now, it's going to take place as scheduled. If you need tickets reissued, all you got to do is call the Coliseum Ticket Office at the number right there on the left side of your screen. The health department says all vaccination appointments for tomorrow have been canceled. Leaders say canceled appointments, though, will be automatically rescheduled for the same time on an alternate day. To see the revised appointment dates, visit the health department's website. Vicksburg Mayor George Flags issuing a statement saying, in part, as we sand down streets and bridges, I'm asking everyone in Vicksburg to stay in unless it is an absolute emergency. If not, I will have to issue an extended civil emergency order with a curfew. The safety of our citizens will always be our first priority.